preemptive disorder, and disaster preparedness, social protection, and then we have the other essential elements like the environmental protection. We have also the tourism. Naiba ko karon because in the previous we call that 3+1. We have to comply the 3 core elements and then we have to add 1 sa mga compliance. Later on this year, as we go through the assessment, kay patawag pa man ini ang mga tao sa central, they decided the new guidelines of 2017, the skilled up kini sa 4+1. So there were several assessments conducted before. That's why if you look at the seal, it was actually 2015 post compliance for Ilomas. So this time we say congratulations to Ilomas. Why don't we give a big hand of applause for Ilomas? Out of the 149 LGUs in the region, there were only 49 municipalities or LGUs who were able to comply with the requirements. And in the province of Baguio, there were only 13 out of 41, and one is Ilomos. So again, congratulations to the mayor and to our Sangguniang and all the functionaries. Our director kept on saying sa among LGUs who were able to garner this award, na if you look at the seal, it says seal of good local governance. So it means it's not only an award given to our functionaries, our LGU, because it's a governance, local governance. So it also refers to the people ang operations sa atong katawan. So it doesn't limit only to the local government unit, but to the whole LGU, to the local government unit. So that's why the cooperation of Corporation Tanan dinhi sa atong tao, dinhi sa Ilomos, was now recognized that you were able to commit this award. Dakunti nga atong nakuha ang award because what we are now looking, the department, especially Region A, came up with what we call the 2G table, or good governance table, where we call a potential awarding, or a sustainable award. That's why Ilomos was one, actually, sa una, sa first batch, no? We called the different LGUs. We look at unsay mga criteria were not met. So looking at the records of Ilomos, more very minor lang siguro. It's more on the BFATs, ang mga kulang mayor, ano, gamay lang. Or only small items. Kung makomply ka, siguro masustain ta. And then we have to look at the new guidelines of 2017. There are several now. We have to look into it and then we have, siguro it's better, we suggest that we call on the different departments to look at the compliance of this criteria para pag-assessment, kasi we will start as the assessment by the end of April until May. No? So when the assessor will come, ready na ang ato mga documents, we are evaluating na the 2016 performance. So ato na tanong on the records. Ang dili natin siguro mag-change or some other like CLUP, we really have to come up with the CLUP. Wala man, per report from COA, wala man ang mga disclaimer for now for sa atong district. Only in some sa second district na sa the province of Leyte, isa lang sa COA report. So, looking at the requirements of the LGU of Ilomos, murang madali nyo makamit po 2016. Although we have, as I said, again, we also are given directives to our MLGO to assist. Kay kami gamon sa province, also in the region, we try to assist the LGO. Kaya hindi ba ni pakurian ang atong LGO. As much as possible, the target of our regional director is Tanan sa the region should be able to accept and receive this award. Kaya dapunti nga, honor na magtawag natin. Kasi looking at the ranking, region, national, ranking sa national, sa SGLG, ang Region 8 was actually second to the last, murang kakuha sa other region. So, our regional director, Marvel sa Central Zero, made some strategies to consult people from the different LGUs, kung sa'y buhaton, kung sa'y nakakasa talagang kulang, and then we have to make up for that shortcomings sa para we sustain also and we also have to receive this award. Para it's a big honor to have this award. Everybody is aspiring to have this seal of good local governance. So it's just easy. I was assigned in Baybay before I was assigned as Clusterman. What I told, and at the same time I'm telling this to our MLGOs, ang atong siguro ka-advise sa atong mga functionaries and the local government unit is to look into the basic, what's the law, what's the requirement, also it requires a law. And bisan wala na guidelines, we look at the law, what are those requirements, and then come up with the required information para kompleto. Di pa ngayon din ang data, we now comply. Para when assessment comes, bisa kung saan pa nila ang guidelines, kasi the guidelines was only created within what was required by the law. So mas madali. So we comply with the law and then we commit the award. Anyway, what we are after is actually the services we are providing to the people. Secondary na lang ang award. If we do these things, later on we commit. So for that, dilin na akong alam ako kay siguro na ito kay Panginoong Bawal. So, again, I would like to congratulate, on behalf of our department, our director, we would like to congratulate the NGO Ilomos. Congratulations and maayong puntag sa inyong tanan.
Thank you so much, Mr. Dorado. Let us now come to the unveiling of the 2015 Seal of Good Local Governance Plaque. May we request our Municipal Mayor, Honorable Albert Villarmasa, together with the Municipal Vice Mayor and the San Bunyan Bayan members, with our LGOO and MLGOO. And our PNB Chief.